Beekeeping is a demanding enterprise. Yes, it's fun. Yes, we get honey. Yes, we enjoy working with bees. But there's a lot of effort that goes into keeping colonies happy, healthy, and productive. Just to start from the top, boxes that bees live in, the hive structure in which the colony lives, is heavy. Each of these boxes can weigh 50 pounds or more. That's the equivalent of 23 or more kilograms. Also in beekeeping, you have to put up with stings. So even on the best beekeeping day, when everything seems to be going well, you can get stung, and just like that, you could stop enjoying what you're doing. Also, the things that we have to do as beekeepers to protect ourselves from sting, like wearing personal protective equipment, can cause a lot of physical problems for us. All of these things are hot and very difficult to wear when it's hot and humid, and it can just be cumbersome, and it can amplify the stress that you have while you are physically working colonies. On top of that, there's this whole part of our industry that relies on moving bees to crops for pollination services, moving bees to different areas for honey production purposes, and moving bees is terrible because it usually requires nighttime work, or it may be weekend work. Also, one of the things that makes beekeeping physically taxing is the use of smoke. Yes, we use smokers all of the time to keep our bees calm, to lessen their defensive behavior while we're working their colonies. There's been really no good longitudinal studies on the effects of smoke on beekeepers, but some people find that smoke annoying, and of course you're going to get it all over your clothes, and so that's also a problem as well. Beekeeping has to be done sometimes in the hot, it sometimes has to be done in the cold, it sometimes has to be done in the sunny, in the dry, in the rainy, and you can find yourself just being physically taxed as you work those colonies during different inclement weather episodes. So collectively, all of these things can make beekeeping a very physical endeavor. The good news is there are mitigation strategies associated with a lot of the things that I've mentioned. For example, there's a really good movement happening right now towards accessible beekeeping to make beekeeping something that folks with physical disabilities are able to do. For example, traditionally our hive boxes accommodate 10 frames. Well, some styles of hives these days accommodate 8 frames, so that removes 20% of the weight associated with it. You don't have to use the deepest, biggest box that we have. Instead, you can use medium supers or shallow supers. You can keep your bee colonies up off of the ground so that you're not constantly finding yourself bending over. So there are mitigation strategies simply with the hive equipment that we have. Thinking specifically about personal protective equipment, it's come a long ways since I started keeping bees. Bee suits, bee gloves, bee veils have increased ventilation, increased durability, the ability to wear these things in much warmer weather and not be so hot throughout the process. And most importantly, a lot of the physical toil associated with beekeeping can just be mitigated with posture and correct movement. For example, a lot of beekeepers have bad lower backs because they've spent their entire career bending over at the hips and picking up all of this heavy equipment. But remember, when you work colonies, to bend your knees. As I mentioned, you can move to smaller boxes with smaller frames. All of these things help ensure that you can have a safe beekeeping hobby or job.